with Loving Life's Little Blessings, and I just have a couple things to share with you guys today. This is my video that is going along with my team news and highlights. Every month, around the 10th of the month, I always share with you guys some cards that I've made for my team, and then usually I'm putting together a little goodie bag for top-end sales is what I usually do. And then sometimes we have a challenge where we've created something or we've made something, and I'm sharing that with you guys. So today I just wanted to share with you guys these cards. I used a freshly picked sketch, and if you head over to my website by clicking this link right up here, it takes you to the coordinating blog post, and I'll put a link in to the sketch that I used. It's an old sketch. I just was in need of making some cards, and so I just went and found a sketch, and that's sometimes what I do when I need to make a card and I don't really have any ideas. I always say I'm not really a card maker. It doesn't really come natural to me to make cards. It's not something that I'm just inspired to do a lot of the times, and so for me, I really love using sketches. So this was a sketch, and I just followed it and made it, and I actually made about 10 of these, and I wanted to show you the paper stack that I used. This is one of our brand new paper stacks, and it is the Stacked with Love Designer Series paper stack, and I really love it because it has all these pinks and corals. Calypso coral is one of the colors that it coordinates with, but then the very back side is just black and white, so it's really a versatile stack to have, and I really do enjoy the colors of this. And so I thought I would show you. I made a card, and my card base is Calypso coral. And then this is just a piece of Whisper White, and I embossed it with the Big Dots embossing folder. And I took a half inch off each side. So the card is 5.5 by 4.25. And then this white base, the next layer, is going to be 5 by 3.75. And then let's just measure these other layers out so you guys can see what I did. This is 1.75, so it's just, I just slightly smaller than 2 inches this way, and then it is 3 inches tall, and then this very bottom layer is 3.25 by 1.5, and then I used a really great stamp set that just coordinates with one of our punches, so I was able to just punch it right out, and I'll put the name of the stamp set right up here because I don't remember what the name of the stamp set is. So I made a handful of these cards, and I'm using those to send out, and then I thought I would show you a really easy way to just put a topper on a bag. So these are 5x7 bags, and I'm putting a thing of rhinestones in the bag, and then I also have some tags and some clips, and I can just close this up. I love these bags that I get. I get them off eBay. And then I've just taken another one of these papers in there, and I've cut this at 5 across. So it's 5 this way, and then let's just measure it because I don't remember exactly. It'd be easier if I measure it. So it is 4.5 by 5, I believe. Yep, 4.5 by 5. So what I can do is I can just fold this right in half. This is a super easy way to do a bag. I'm using my ATG tape just because it's stronger. And then I'm just gonna set this down. Just like that. And then I'm taking the chevron ribbon. I love our chevron ribbon. It's one of my favorite ribbons we've ever had. It's super easy to tie and work with. I love the colors. I just love everything about it. So I can just tie it like that. So I'm not even really, I'm not doing a bow. I mean, it's just super simple. And we'll trim this up. just like that. And then we'll just make this right over to the side, like so. And then I've just taken my heart punch and I've punched out some glimmer paper. This is some old, it's our old silver color. So our silver glimmer paper now is a little bit more silver. It's more of a gray, has more of a gray to it. And this was just a little scrap I had on hand. So I didn't even get a full sheet out or anything. I just grabbed a piece of scrap glimmer paper I had. And then I'm just gonna put dimensionals on that. And I'm gonna stick that right on this, right on the ribbon. And look at how cute that is. Super simple. It was really easy to do, really easy to put together, and then I'll have a card that goes with it, and that's what I'll be sending my downline this month. So I'm really excited that Celebrations has started, and you can join Stampin' Up, and it's in a really, you get a really amazing deal when you join Stampin' Up. So if you're interested in joining and getting some free product, please contact me. You can always email me, leave me a comment, and I'll get back to you. I'll email you back and we can chat, and it's a great time to join Stampin' Up, and I would love to have you join my team. So thank you guys so much for coming by, and I will be back again with more fun projects. Thanks, guys. I'll talk to you later.